All right, so while I was about to get up there and start doing that fan shroud, I got this in the mail, and if this is what I think it is, I don't know, let's see. Oh boy, it's wrapped up tighter than a duck's butt. Came with a free koozie. All right, so for views that are not in the know, this is a oil cooler back flush from Fixture 6. Basically, this sits, let's go over to the truck and I'll show you where it sits. Well, all right. Back under there is a cap, and this right here will sit on top of it, and you can raise this and it will lower. You can lower this valve, and you can stick a water hose on here and with air and water back flush your system and get all the shit out of your oil cooler so that you can decrease your deltas between your engine coolant temp and your oil coolant. All right, welcome back to another episode of This Old House. We gotta get that son of a biscuit eater out of there. It's gonna be a pain in the ass with this wire loom in the way. Let's see if I can get it without taking that out. Alright, so move wires out of the way, whatever the hell you gotta do. I should have done this whenever I had the turbo out of the truck. It's just a pain in the ass. But, get down in there. I used like a focus. I used a swivel with like a socket that went to a T30, and then the backside I had to get with this joker right here, which was a pain in thing in my jigger, pain in the ass. All right, get that off of there, and then you got to somehow manage to get this taller son of a bitch in there. All right, let's see how this fucking works. All right, well, those little nuts or screws are a big pain in the ass to get in there. There's not a whole lot of room in there, so I'm curious to see how this works, to getting a hose on that thing and everything. But I got to go to Home Depot, and I got to build something to put on it. I'll be back. All right, so to build mine, I am going to get this Y. And I got this female thread to a quick connect that's gonna go to the oil cooler. Okay. And then I got this male connector double-sided, so it's gonna connect that to the water hose. So, it's a little hard doing it one-handed and staring at the screen instead of what I'm working on. All right, so the tricky part is getting air to it as well. So I went over, this is all the garden department over here, and then I went over to fittings and stuff like that, and I got this garden hose cap, which is gonna go right there. Now, the tricky part, how am I gonna get that in there? Well, I'm gonna drill and tap that, tighten that in there, and boom, done. I haven't seen many people show how they build all theirs. I've just seen people show theirs on the internet. So here's mine. I'm gonna drill and tap this, and I'll come back and show you it fully put together. All right, so I really screwed the pooch on that whole drill and tap job. But luckily I had some JB Weld handy. So I JB Welded the shit out of this JB Water Weld. I've had success with it in other applications before. So give this focus. Give this 60 minutes or so to cure, and then we'll see if it'll hold air. So there she is, and she's in her glory. Water hose hooks in there. Air hooks in there. Hose goes all the way down on top of the Fixture 6 oil cooler back flush. And then just to hit it with some air, you just turn the nozzle on and off. You leave the water on and then just hit it on and off with the air. I just put this on here so I can show you guys. I'm gonna hose clamp this. It is pretty tight, but I'm still gonna hose clamp it. Just gotta give that time to cure, and then we'll be good to test her out. Alright, so let's start by saying I successfully back flushed the dog piss out of my truck. But there's things to note here. I didn't let this set long enough, so it had leaks. If you're gonna buy one of these Y connectors, spend the few extra dollars or order the one from Fixture 6. I figured I could save a few bucks to do this myself, but it's just a piece of crap. That lever popped off, and then I had air and water coming out of that. It wasn't until the very end, though. So, I mean, I accomplished my goal of getting it flushed, but, yeah, it broke. So, now I'm going to get the water hose off of there. Everything's wet as hell. And tighten up the cap on it and be done with it. Put all this shit back together. Gotta wait till tomorrow because I got my belts coming in tomorrow. And then I can have it running, hopefully. All right, so when you're done with your back flush, what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna get, I don't know, probably like 10 to 14 gallons of distilled water, because you don't want any of the minerals that are in like city water to, under temperatures and whatnot, cake up your oil cooler system, because the oil cooler is very fucking finicky in these 6.0s. Just minute amounts of like debris can clog it up and make your oil cooler not function properly. But so you're gonna do, I did 3 rounds of flushing after, I did 3 rounds of radiator flushing after the oil cooler back flush. And once that was all said and done and I drained out the last bit of distilled water, I went with the Motorcraft gold concentrate. Some people use Rotella ELC. I went with the Motorcraft. I put 3 gallons of the concentrate in there, and then I filled the rest with distilled water. It's very important you use distilled water, or else you're gonna be back flushing your system again very fucking soon. But all right, that's the end of that tale. That'll get you through it. Peace.